Hello for Tuesday, December 9th, and on Monday, what a great day. You know, the market opened with a gap, and so there were four from our watch list. Our watch list was packed with stuff, and four of them gapped up over, so you could only play those with 15-minute rule, or you could play them however you want to, but that'd be the suggested way. But never mind, there were seven more from the watch list that did trigger in the normal way, and all closed up higher, made significant gains, some in the double digits. Just a great, great day overall. And so the market's just the way they look. This is the Dow. It doesn't show the gap, but there is a gap. And, of course, it was running up. Remember, it's facing this resistance as it gets close to the 50-day EMA, which is now at 9,070. Note that there is this horizontal line as well. This comes from over here where it was, a closed down one day, and then it opened the next day right at that point. This shows the shadows at around 9,159. It's a little bit lower than that. 9,150 area, then we've got the 9,070 area, 50-day. We should expect some resistance, and not that it just shoot right through there, unless there's big, some crazy news that will do that, but it's still getting a runaway. Now, some people like to count this as a head and shoulders, a reverse head and shoulders, with the head being, right here, the left shoulder over here, the right shoulder over here. It could be. Maybe it will act that way. It's not a very good-looking head and shoulders, but if you treated it that way, From the distance of the bottom of the head here, 7,500 up to 88, that's what, 1,300 points. So if you had 1,300 points on to 8,800, you come up to 10,100. That's far short of the 200-day, but it does get us up into here. We won't look at that now, but it does get us above. But we know, anyway, we have resistance overhead here. Then we got resistance 9,653. That was this next line up. But so far, it's been a good day. And look, where RSI is only at 53, so in even stochastics isn't really overbought. Now, short-term-wise, though, we think it is a bit. We'll look over here at the 15-minute chart. And this was not a good setup because of the steep move up here. Remember, here's the support from back over on December 1st, I guess that is, at 8,828, and so there was a pullback. And if you look, we showed this on the blog, there was like this selling, the normal selling indicators here, but the problem was it hadn't broken below this when it came, so this would still give support. And if you looked at the 3-minute charts, or where we gave the pivot points, because stock charts does not have pivots, you can't put them on, but the pivot points were listed, this came down to about resistance 1, and as it came down to that area, that it dropped just a little bit below it, almost coincides here, and then it started moving back up and made new highs of the day. So if you did go short at this point, you still would not have broken this resistance. So as it moved up, you would have been stopped out there. Now look, we do have some negative divergence still here. RSI and MACD now could overcome that, but we think we'll probably drop lower. We'll see how it goes. But back below this area, then we're looking to move down to perhaps 87.39, or then 38% at 88 or 86.80 and change. Look at the larger size charts for that. If we look at the SPX, once again, it has some negative divergence. This is where the high was in the RSI here, and it's a little bit lower even though it ran up higher itself. And we don't have MACD on this chart. So we're still, once again, as it dropped down, it still held the same basic region. So we'd have to see a drop below this 900. It's a little bit higher than that. And then we're looking at the trend line here. So the trend line's at around 890 at the moment. Then 885 is the 50-day, and the gap. So eventually it will come down at least to the top of the gap and probably fill it. We'll see how it goes as it gets down here. Now the Russell, this one did the same as the index, the Dow, and that is it got our normal sell signals like that we look for, all four of them actually, and you can see actually we're still on a sell in the MACD. But this did the same thing as it pulled down to, it never had broken this basic main support area here. As you can see, there's no trend line set up over here. It's very clear. When you look for the good areas, you like to see very something clean, like here we have one touch, two touch. This was very clean in the area. There's nothing around it whatsoever. Over here, this little break up here, well, on the left, there's all kinds of support. It could come at any point. So even though it was a short, I think you would have been stopped out very quickly unless you took your 1 or 2 point quick gains, because there was just too much support here. So now we'd look for a break. We haven't drawn a trend line. You could here at the center Bollinger Band, roughly at about 473, somewhere in here. There's still a bit of support, but the farther away you get from support time-wise, the weaker it gets. Then 465 is the 50-period EMA and also near the gap. So now we've got additions to the watch. There's quite a number here. We have to make up for all those that, not make up for all of them, but we had so many that, triggered. We'll add several more. Now, some of these are, of course, very bullish, and they may have to pull back. They've moved up well, like 16% EGLE over about 459. It's at 436. It could pull back in here, but look, higher volume. That is encouraging for it. Next up, we've got this one looks pretty good, actually. Let me point out that this is a good one. Eagle has 1.7 million shares, so there's no problem. Some of them will show today have some low volume stocks, so as always, a little risky when you're low volume. Also, I wanted to show on this chart, we're just passing up over stochastics over 20. It's just 2014, just starting to get positive a little bit on histogram, and MACD may cross over in RSI. So if this can get going, then we could see a move back up into this range where we've got basically like an almost a little gap up here around wherever that is at around $6, something like that. So EGLE is one to watch there. Now DRE is one that's already broken. We'll show it because we posted this when it was at 834. We posted it in the on the blog, because it looked like it had some okay volume coming in. Oh, it was 6 million shares at the time, and it closed over 7 million shares. So it had good volume coming in, and we saw this 836, so a couple cents early. So if you got in from checking the blog, from 835 ran up to 890, so that's good. So right now we'll just call this continuation play, and this would be over this, over this level. You'll just have to see how it goes. So we don't have an exact level for it, but if it continues, if the market continues, we could get back up into this area once again near the 50 period. Okay, next up we've got DW. And this is a top level of 1585, or perhaps on a pullback within this area. Let's say now 1454, I'm sorry. It did pull back. Earlier it had been up above this, so changed my mind. At 1454, back over there would be the first buy, and then 1585 would be the top area. Okay, now we'll get on to this one, which is CYN over 940, the first area, and then 990 would be the second area, but 940 looks like pretty good in this area. But because of this down candle, maybe it'll hit resistance and won't break through, but we'll wait for that. Go to the watch list to see the bigger size charts, by the way, and this. Now Hanson Natural, this one is setting up, and you notice where its top is, right exactly at the 200-day EMA. So if it can break above that, around $30.12, we'd like to see good volume. Right now the volume's bad. It's higher volume on the downside than the up, but that can turn around if it does over 30.12. We'd be interested in buying HANS. Now we've got one that could be a short, could be a long. Earlier, not long before the close, it looked like it was going to break down below this area. It's a short below about 575. Or long somewhere once it gets over this congestion, maybe around 7. You can play it how you like. We present it. We did see increased volume, but early in the day it looked like it break down and has turned around. CHUX was one of these big movers for the day. There are several stocks that, of course, really took off. This was up over 55%, as you can see. It's running right up into resistance here, but it was good volume. And look, we've just got RSI breaking. We don't even have stochastics breaking. We just got a crossover on MACD. So it's possible if Chucks goes sideways for a while, it could have a breakout over 213. Looks like a possibility there. And lastly, one more stock, and that is BEE, another momentum play, having strong volume, 3.9 million shares. This broke above this 145 and then went up to as high as, what was this high for the day, about 167, and pulled back below the 145, so back over 145. But just be aware, use caution when you start off the day like that. It'd be better if it pulls back first. Anyway, those are the additions we have for today. We thank you a lot for coming by the site. Hope you have a good day trading, and we'll be back tomorrow with some new ideas. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.